Ambre de Kesusia. Our Father, we give you thanks. Lift your hand and glorify his name. Thank you, mighty God. In the name of Jesus, we have prayed. Please, you may be seated.
My case is different. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. This morning, it is testimony time. Please listen to the following documented testimonies and be blessed. Number one, no more lying, humanizing, and divine visitation. I am an automobile electrician. There is no way we will do any job without telling lies. We always inflated the prices of things bought. Also, I was a humanizer. Last Sunday, after hearing the message on holiness from the bishop, I couldn't get up from my seat to walk home. He said, if you have all those useless things of the world in your house, throw them away. Also, he said, if you are in a place where evil is done, but you don't join them, you also partake in the cause that befalls them. On getting home, I gathered all the useless pornographic pictures in my house and tore them all. Then I said, God, I need a change. I want to live a holy life. So I quit my place of work where I used to lie and inflate prices of goods. As I started looking for another job, God showed up. Hallelujah. It wasn't long when a relation of mine met me and said they have been looking for me for many days. I told them I was no longer working, that I was looking for another job because I wanted to live a holy life. He said plans have been concluded to buy me a new bus. We are going to collect the bus tomorrow. I thank God. The testifier is Ezekiel S. Number two, delivered from indebtedness. I'm here to honor the vow I made to God at the viewing center in Kampala in 2013. I attended that Shiloh with a financial debt of 38 million Uganda shillings. At that Shiloh, I sold my laptop as sacrifice, which was literally the only thing I had remaining. Later on, I gave the car that I got back from the money lenders. I'm here to return the glory to God because 3 months later, the 38 million shillings was paid miraculously. If it is for Jesus, make it bigger. Amen. The ministry went down from 70 to about 14 people. But after the minister's conference I attended in May 2016, I want to testify that on our 6th anniversary in June, we had a record attendance of 1,000. I return all the glory to God. The testifier is Pastor Anthony Muhumuza. Rise to your feet and lift up your hands and give God glory. Father, we thank you. Blessed be your name, in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Let's lift up our hands this morning, magnify the Lord for the privilege to be alive this morning. Appreciate him. The psalmist said, I slept, I awake because the Lord sustained me. Let's give him praise and glory. He's faithful. He's a good God. Father, we appreciate you. Now, Lord, speak to me this morning, day unto day, uttered speech. Lord, the speech for this morning, I desire to hear from you. Let's lift up our hands and just ask him to speak directly to us this morning. Send your word our way, and all the glory we shall return to you. Blessed be your name forevermore. In Jesus' precious name. My case is different, and let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Please put your hands together for the Lord as you take your seat. Praise the Lord. We'll be continuing in our exhortation lines for this week, captioned, Engaging Relevant Spiritual Forces for a Sanctified Life. Engaging relevant spiritual forces for a sanctified life. We began by saying this week that we are in the last days. where forces of defilement are raging against the redeemed to get us out of the faith. 2 Timothy chapter 3 and verse 1 to 5, scripture begins by saying, in the last days, perilous times shall come. Now, jumping from that to 1 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 1, he said, now the Spirit speaketh expressly that in the later times, just talked about as the last days, some shall depart from the faith. And he went on to say, giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. Verse 2, he said, speaking lies in hypocrisy, having their conscience sneered with hot iron. We're reading all the way to verse 5, verse 3. He went on to say, forbidding to marry and commanding to abstain from meats, which God hath created to be received with thanksgiving of them which believe and know the truth. And then, for every creature of God is good and nothing to be refused, if it be received with thanksgiving. Then finally, verse 5, he said, for it is sanctified by the word of God and with prayer. So in these last days, there will be departure. While there is arrival to the faith, there is also departure from the faith. And this is why we are examining this very important aspect. In Jude chapter 1 and verse 3, he said that we ought to contend earnestly for the faith. So staying in the faith takes a fight. And this is why we've been examining some of these relevant forces. And today we'll be looking at two of them. Number one is the mystery of the Holy Communion. Relevant forces for a sanctified life, the mystery of the Holy Communion. And we understand that the Holy Communion is not just what we do, it's what we have been commanded to do. In John chapter 6 and verse 57, when we eat the flesh and drink the blood of Jesus, we are empowered to live like him. He said, as the living Father sent me and I live by the Father, so he that eateth me, even he shall live by me or like me. When we take the Holy Communion, we are spiritually transfused with eternal life. The same John chapter 6 and verse 54 and verse 55. John 6 and verse 54. He went on to say, whoso eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood had eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day. For my flesh is meat indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. So partaking of the communion is having eternal life transfused into us. We also understand that when we partake of the communion in faith, we are delivered from death. And we know the wages of sin is death. Romans chapter 6 and verse 23. So the mystery of the Holy Communion is our overcomer's meal. In Revelation chapter 12 and verse 11, it said they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of their testimony. So every time we partake of the Holy Communion, we are partaking of the overcomer's meal. It infuses in us overcoming capacity over sin. Therefore, I know that as we yet again partake of the Holy Communion tonight at the midweek service, every one of us struggling with one form of addiction or the other, entering in and falling out of sin, it shall be crushed in the name of Jesus. Your amen should be louder this morning. We also understand that every time we partake of the communion, we are purging our conscience from dead works to serve the living God. That is clearly stated in Hebrews chapter 9 and verse 14. Secondly, the relevant force to be engaged to live a sanctified life is that we must come out of every ungodly association. Those you fellowship with are those you agree with. In 2 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 14 down to verse 18, verse 14 specifically, he said, be not unequally yoked with unbelievers. First Corinthians chapter 15 and verse 33, he said, be not deceived. Evil communication corrupts good manners. Our association, in terms of living a sanctified life, you associate with a thief, it is automatic. You associate with a fornicator, it's automatic. We must be cautious of those we associate with. We must be cautious of those we fellowship with in order to live a sanctified life. This is very crucial and very important as we are in the last days where many are departing from the faith. Those who will stand in the faith are those who are cautious of who they fellowship with. Grace, therefore, to fellowship with the right company is delivered to us in the name of Jesus. As we round up this morning, I think it's important that we state the following facts, that sanctification is possible. In 1 Peter chapter 1 and verse 15 to 16, it states it very clearly. Be ye holy. It began by saying, but as he which had called you is holy, so be ye holy in all manner of conversation. And verse 16, he said, but it is written, be ye holy, for I am holy. So the subject matter of this month and this week is a possibility. No matter how many are falling out, day in, day out, there are still those who are standing. Sanctification is possible. Number two, we must also understand that sanctification is profitable. It's not only possible, it is profitable. First Timothy, chapter 4 and verse 8. He said, for bodily exercise profited little, but godliness is profitable. If you like, sanctification is profitable unto all things, having the promise of the life that now is and that which is to come. So sanctification is not only possible, it is profitable. I'd like us to conclude by saying sanctification is not just possible, profitable, it is also powerful. The Bible says in Romans chapter 1 and verse 4 that Jesus Christ was declared to be the Son of God according to the Spirit of holiness. The declaration of Christ was on the platform of his holiness. And he went on to say, by the resurrection of the dead. In Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 4, it said, Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 14, it said, that without holiness, no man shall see the Lord. It said, follow peace with all men and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. That's the power of sanctification. No matter our prayer life, without sanctification, eternity is not to be discussed. This is very clear. And I believe God that as we've received this word this morning, grace to live a sanctified life, not just when others are watching, but in secret, that our conversation will be as becometh godliness, will be as becometh holiness, that grace is released upon us in the name of Jesus. So shall it be in Jesus' mighty name. Would you please like to rise on your feet and like us to pray very passionately now this morning. Father, help me. In this matter of sanctification, I need your help. Let's lift up our voices and pray. Remember, the prayer altar is the altar of helps. Let's lift up our voices this morning as we pray. Lord, I desire your help. I desire your help in my conversation, in my thoughts. I desire your help. I desire your help. I desire your help. I desire your help. Are we praying at all? Let's lift up our voices right now. Father, I desire your help. I desire your help. I desire your help. Let's pray very passionately. Lord, I desire your help. I desire your help as it relates to holiness. I desire your help. It is possible. It is profitable. It is powerful. Lord, I desire your help this morning. Father, thank you for your help. Let's thank him in advance for his 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 help. Father, thank you in the name of Jesus Christ. That help from God has been released to us all. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Lift your hand to heaven, and for God's word that you have received this morning, give him thanks. Appreciate him. Glorify the name of the Lord for the word that you have received. Appreciate him. Glorify him. Celebrate him. Our Father, we thank you. We give you praise and glory and honor and adoration. We celebrate your faithfulness because you have done all things well. You have done all things well. You have done all things well. We glorify your holy name. We glorify your holy name. We celebrate you, Jesus. You are worthy of all the praise. You are worthy of all the glory. Are you giving God thanks this morning? It says, sanctify them by thy truth, because thy word is truth. His word has come this morning again to give you a shower, to cleanse you, to purify you. Celebrate him and glorify his holy name. Our Father, we thank you. Our Father, we glorify you. You are worthy of all the praise and of all the glory, the honor and of all the adoration. We are grateful, Lord. We are grateful, Father. We are thankful. We are thankful. We celebrate you, Jesus. You are worthy of all the praise. You are worthy of all the glory and all the honor and all the adoration. Lero shambra deketona mananglaria grado sheteriam bradaka talaro zuziambara. Lora bandredi ketonam baraka shapradi ketonam bala baradia kando zodiam brados. We are grateful, Lord. Blessed be your holy name. 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 Glory to the Father. Thank you, mighty God. In the name of the Lord Jesus, we have prayed. In a moment, we are going to speak to the Lord personally. The Bible says that it's God that works in us both to will and to do of his good pleasure. Pleasing God demands help from God. And we are going to secure helps from God in the form of grace, because the scripture says, let us come boldly to the throne of grace to obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. Sufficient for each day is the evil thereof. There are enough temptations and opportunity to fall, but there's enough opportunity to win. And we can call on God today for grace. Lord, I am asking you. Remember, we're told by God's servant, our Father, the prayer to win the battle against temptation is a daily one. Lord, I'm asking you today for grace to maintain dominion over sin. Sin shall not have dominion over me. Lift up your voice and pray this morning. I call upon you this morning, my Father. I'm asking you for the release of grace. Grace to maintain dominion over sin. To maintain dominion over sin. To maintain dominance over sin. Rabate predia canto shabarada gala. The grace, O Lord, to maintain dominion over sin. This morning, I call upon you today, asking for the release of that grace. Let it be made available to me. In the name of the Lord Jesus. The grace, O Lord, for dominion over sin. I call upon you today to maintain that dominion. I receive grace today. Rabande prodia canoshada balakato zuzia balata lerombre die kenetosia. Remember, it's not by power, neither is it by mind, but by the Spirit of the Lord. My Father, I call upon you this morning, asking for the empowerment of your Spirit to maintain dominion. Sin shall not have dominion under me, over me. Rabaketo krediketo shaba lembranderia galatosusia. By the grace that I call upon you for this morning, my dominion is maintained. My feet remain firmly on the neck of the enemy. Rabanda la kosusie kenosha, elambra no koto prodia barandia katasusia, lero predi kanto pananda
kantopananda barompananke tengelika tambo bembrodi angala tambo repredike ne titiata allo brande ricche tosusia arushambeleketedia el hombre neko susia ba. My Father, I call upon you this morning, decreeing, O Lord, that grace be made available, Lord, for the maintenance of dominion over sin. Rabale credia canasusia, lerusha pandele ketombedia, gacomparala, lembranike tosusia. I will not fall a prey, I remain in dominion. Lerusam prendeke tonambalaga, rabando roporia malatalo, lekosha pandeliaga, la rambrede kendolia maradocala. Embrende rica tosia, lembronda banda la bacando roboliba rangala tosiangala. We give you thanks, O Lord. Lift your hand and your voice and begin to glorify the name of the Lord. If you know that he has heard your prayer, give him thanks. Father, we give you thanks. We give you the praise and the glory, the honor and the adoration. Accept our thanksgiving, Lord. In the precious name of the Lord Jesus, we have prayed. And somebody believes, say a loud amen. Amen. Please take your seat for a moment as we receive these closing announcements and instructions. Be reminded again, today being Wednesday, we have our midweek service. Remember, we're waiting on the Lord. And each one of us are reminded to engage the day with focus to make the most of what God has in store for us today. Remember, we have been told over and over again, spiritual vacation is what? It's a risk. It is one. It's a risk. This is not the time to say, you see, this Wednesday is towards the end of the year. It's not really necessary that I fast. Christmas so near to us. No. If spiritual vacation is what is a risk. Therefore, make the most of the day. You have free time through the day. That's the time to engage it the best. Engage it on the altar of prayer. Engage it in study of the word. And make the most of all that God has today. And remember, we're gathered today again this evening at the evening communion service, which is taking place at 6 p.m. and where we'll be breaking our fast with the communion. So come expectant, because God himself will be visiting you and visiting me for a change of story in the name of Jesus Christ. The year is concluding. The blessings are pouring. He crowns the year with his goodness, and his paths drop fatness. The fattest blessings of the year will answer for you in this season. Yeah. I said the fattest blessings of the year will answer for you in this season. Yeah. Let's take note of those instructions and the Lord richly bless you. Would you rise on your feet with me, lift your hand to heaven and glorify God for the blessing of this day. Glorify him for the blessing of the day. Thank you, Lord, for the blessing of this day. I give you the praise. I celebrate you for the privilege to begin this day in your presence. I celebrate you. Thank you, mighty God, in Jesus' precious name. Keep your hand lifted. Now, as you go this morning, go under the covering of heaven. Amen. You go in peace, and you are returning with testimonies. Amen. All through this day, the favor of God answers for you. Amen. Wherever your name is represented today, it will answer for favor. Decree that all through this day, there shall be no rejection for you. Wherever you appear, acceptance shall become your experience. In the name of the Lord Jesus, this day is decreed a blessed day. This day is decreed a testimony day. This day is decreed a good news day. No evil tidings are permitted from any corner today. From every angle today, it shall be good news on every side. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. He said he daily loaded us with benefits. Therefore, the load, not the trickle, but the load that is appertained for this day will locate you in the name of Jesus. Wherever you are found, the load that God has packaged for this day will locate you in the name of Jesus. So shall it be. Today we are waiting upon the Lord. Therefore, it becomes a day of encounters. Revelation and insight becomes your portion today in the name of the Lord Jesus. For every one member of